How is it possible that a device costing between 1,000 and 1,500 euros becomes useless overnight? Is it a coincidence? Not at all. Today I'm going to show you how Apple is making their flagship product end up in electronic waste much sooner than it should. And the worst part is that they're doing it on purpose. This device arrived at our workshop from a client who found us online. The customer told us that the screen wouldn't turn on, a more common issue in these devices than it seems. Let's disassemble it step by step. We'll remove the screws and protectors, but we won't dwell too much on this process. There's something far more important I want to show you. What you'll see next is key, both for Apple users and for technicians trying to repair these devices. This issue is not random. It's a direct consequence of Apple's own design. Now I'm going to show you. To replace the screen, battery, or any other internal component, it's crucial to first disconnect the battery connector. But here's the problem. Disconnecting the battery is not as simple as it should be. To do it properly, you must follow a series of precise steps. Here you can see the battery connector, located right underneath the motherboard. This placement is no accident. It's part of a design that complicates repairs. If the battery connector is not properly separated from the motherboard before continuing, you risk causing a short circuit that could render the iPad completely useless. Now I'll show you how to avoid this mistake and protect your device. Let's move to the microscope for a closer look. We use a microscope with 45x magnification, capable of reaching up to 90x, which allows us to observe in detail what's happening at this critical point in the device. This short circuit can occur for several reasons. The most common one is improper handling during disassembly. It's important to remember that in many cases, it's difficult to disconnect the battery connector without first removing the screen flex cables. However, doing it this way is crucial to avoid bigger problems. What's curious is that this design seems intentional. I have no doubt that Apple did this on purpose. They could have chosen an FPC connector, like the ones used in iPhones, which greatly facilitates disconnection and reduces the risk of damage. But they didn't. Besides handling issues, other factors can also cause this failure. Overheating of the component. Voltage overload, moisture or corrosion damage. We won't get into technical details now, but there's something key you should know. With the battery connected, we should find the corresponding battery voltage at this point. However, when this component burns out, that voltage is lost, and as a result, no power will reach the screen connector, leaving the iPad seemingly dead. Now I'll show you how to identify this issue and solve it safely. Before looking for the damaged component, we'll perform a quick test that can save us time. The trick is to create a temporary bridge using a copper wire connecting both ends of the affected component. This will allow us to check if the iPad has additional issues or if the problem is limited to this area. Coincidence? I don't think so. I'm convinced this design was intentional. It's a perfect trap so that both regular users and less experienced technicians make this mistake and end up with a device seemingly destined for the scrap heap. Could it have been designed better? Absolutely. A more accessible connector, like the FPC connectors Apple uses in their iPhones, would have prevented this unnecessary risk. But that's not the case, and now I'll explain why this design seems intended to complicate repairs. This is Apple's trick, and it's where much of the problem lies. To disconnect the battery connector, you first have to remove this protection, then disassemble all the screws, and finally insert a pick or plastic card to separate the battery from the motherboard. Where's the problem? Here's the critical part. During this entire process, the screen must remain connected. The issue is that in these iPad models, the screen flex cables are very short, which makes the job extremely difficult. There's barely any room to maneuver, and if you lift the screen a little too far, you may internally damage one of the flex cables, ruining the screen without even realizing it. It's as if every step was designed for something to go wrong. If it's not the battery flex, it's the screen flex, and so on. There's always an unnecessary risk that could have been avoided with a more logical and accessible design. For this reason, when it comes to repairing these devices, the best option is to go to an experienced professional workshop or directly to the official service center. Handling an iPad Pro without the proper knowledge can turn a simple repair into a costly and irreversible failure. This type of design only reinforces the idea that Apple is not exactly making it easy to repair their devices. Here's the simple truth. Does anyone really believe that Apple couldn't have placed an accessible battery connector on top of the motherboard, as they do in iPhones? Of course they could have, but they're not interested. For Apple, it's more profitable for a 1,500 euro iPad Pro to end up as electronic waste, forcing the customer to buy a new one, rather than facilitating an easy repair that would extend the device's lifespan. And then they sell us the tale of sustainability, recycling, and green technology. Does anyone really believe that narrative? I seriously doubt it. To these big brands, I'll say just one thing. When we buy a device, we pay for it, and we pay well. That device becomes our property, and therefore we have the right to repair it. Any manufacturer should facilitate that process instead of placing obstacles that ultimately condemn functional devices to electronic waste. Decades ago, brands competed to build the best product, the most durable and resilient. Today, it seems the competition has shifted to who can generate the most electronic waste in the shortest time while making millions off our hard work. We live in an age of excessive consumerism, and it's truly a shame because we have the knowledge and technology to do things right. We could build robust, easy to repair devices with much longer lifespans. This is just a reflection, but time will tell. There will come a point when this cycle of excessive consumption will implode. And then what? Who will they sell to when there's no more room to keep exploiting consumers? What these multinationals are doing right now is simply short-term gain at the expense of long-term consequences. This same pattern has repeated itself in many areas, and banks are a clear example. There used to be small savings banks and local banks that offered a close and personal service. Today, those entities have almost completely disappeared, and large banking corporations are shutting down more physical branches each day, while customer service continues to deteriorate. We've been brainwashed, and what's most concerning is that many times we become so comfortable or indifferent that we can't even bother to support good content or leave a simple like. Big multinationals have learned to exploit our effort and time to the fullest, getting rich off others' hard work while product and service quality keeps declining. As a technician, I can tell you that repairing an iPad Pro is pure luck. The risk of damaging a screen that costs hundreds of euros is huge. And then during reassembly, everything gets even more complicated because you have to handle the screen tilted, constantly risking damage to the flex cables. And how hard would it have been to place longer flex cables in a top-positioned FPC battery connector, like those they already use in their own iPhones? It's not about technology or cost. They simply take us for fools, relying on their economic power to do whatever they want. knowing they can silence any uncomfortable voice. If videos like this reach 5 or 10 million people, things would surely start to change. But sadly, it often feels like we've earned this scenario through years of accepting irresponsible consumption models, and now we're paying the price. Even so, I want to make something clear. Every small gesture counts. Every time you share information, support honest content, or make more conscious consumer decisions, you are adding your grain of sand. And let's not forget that mountains are built with many grains of sand. To repair a device like this, it's not enough to just have the right tools. You also need some experience and, honestly, a lot of luck to avoid further issues during the process. I'm Leonardo. This was my reflection for today. See you in the next video. Best regards.